I'm Anil Kumar, and in this video, we will see how to find probability when few conditions are given to us. The question here is, a family is chosen at random from the set of all families with exactly two children. Find the probability that the family has two boys if it is known that one child is a boy. Another question from the same scenario is, find the probability that the family has two boys when it is known that the first child is a boy. So we have two very related questions. And in these questions, we need to find the probability that the family has two boys. But we have different pre-existing conditions. In the first one, we are saying one of the child is a boy. And the second one, we are saying first child is the boy, right? So that makes a huge difference. Let us see how. So let's begin with making a tree diagram. And let's say this is the first child, and then this is the second child. Now, probability of having a boy or a girl is 50-50, correct? So we could write here for the first child, boy or a girl, is it okay? And now for the second also, it is 50-50, correct? So we can write here, if first is the boy, the second one could be boy or a girl. If first is a girl, then also second one could be boy or a girl. Now that gives us a couple of combinations. One is we have a boy and a boy. Then we have boy and a girl. Then we have girl and a boy. And then two girls, right? So this is the first child, that's the second child. Now let's define our events. Event A is two boys, right? So we are defining events here. We'll say event A is two boys, and event B, in this case, is if it is known that one child is a boy. So one is boy, one is boy, right? It could be first or second. That's what it means. Any one of the two could be a boy, right? So that is what it is. Now from here, what is the probability of a boy, right? Two boys. So for two boys, the probability is this, correct? And what is the probability of having one boy in the first one is one boy, that is, we can say these three, right? These three. In these three out of four, we find that we have at least one boy, right? It could be either the first one or the second one, right? So it is one of these two, right? So now let's write down these probabilities also. So the probability of having one of the boys out of the four, that is probability for the event B to happen, is 3 out of 4, right? And what is the probability of their intersection to happen? That is to say, when the one of them is a boy, both are boys. So we see there is only one choice, right? So probability of both A and B to happen. So and B to happen is 1 out of 4, right? Now what we need to find is to find the probability when A happens, which is two boys, when it's already given to us that B has occurred, right? So B is 100%, that's what it means, right? For that, the formula is probability of A intersection B divided by probability of B. So in our case, probability of A intersection B is 1 over 4 divided by 3 over 4, right? And that gives us a value which is 4, 4 cancels, we get 1 over 3. So the probability of a family having two boys, if it is known that one child is a boy is 1 over 3. You get the point, right? Now let's do the second. The second condition is the family has two boys when it is known that the first child is a boy, right? So first child is a boy, that means we have two options. So in this case, the event B, so event B, A is same for us. We say event A is two boys. And event B is first boy. Okay. So in this particular case, the probability when event A happens and B has already occurred is 1 out of 4 as it was last time. However, the probability for event B to happen, that means first one to be a boy, is 2. There are only these two, right? Where first one is the boy, is 2 out of 4. And therefore, the probability of two boys when the first one is B, boy, is written as probability of A intersection B, I mean this was intersection and, right, okay, divided by probability of B, which is 1 over 4 divided by 2 over 4. And that gives us the answer 1 over 2 is 50%. Do you see that? So it is 0.5 or 50%. So in probability questions, the answers may differ if pre-existing conditions are different, as we saw in this example. I hope that helps. I'm Anil Kumar. You can share and subscribe my videos to understand and do better in your exams. Thank you and all the best.